Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Michael Rogers. I'm the Director of Music and Performing Arts here in Plainview at Bethpage. And tonight you're in for a treat. Before you are some very, very talented students who put together an absolutely wonderful program in music. But before we get into the performance, there's many, many people that need to be thanked. First, here at Plainview at Bethpage John F. Kennedy High School, we have a fantastic music department. And this evening you will hear the music of three fine teachers. First, Mr. Glenn Rubin, our esteemed orchestra teacher, who will be coming out in just a few minutes. Mr. David Hirsch, and our newest member of the faculty, Mr. Brian Carter. Let's give them a round of applause for the work they've done. But we know that a building doesn't run without their fantastic leadership, and here we have some of the best in the form of the assistant principals and principals here at JFK High School. That includes Mrs. Vanessa Barboni. She just got married. Let's give her a hand. Mr. Eric Harathunian, who in a few months will go from a family of two to a family of three. Let's give him a hand. Of course, Mr. Philip Farrelly, our other assistant principal, and Mr. James Murray, our principal. Even beyond that, a program doesn't run without the support of the central administration. And we have some of the best here in Nassau County, Long Island, and New York State. This is evidenced by their constant support of the music department and their presence at so many of our events. Dr. Laura Lewis, who is here with us this evening. Ms. Jill Garrosh, Dr. Vincent Mulieri, and Mr. Richard Cunningham. Really, just a fine cabinet of superintendents. We are very lucky here in Plainview to have such a wonderful administration. But above all, the most support comes from our fantastic and unconditionally supportive Board of Education. Without them, we would really not have the wood that makes the fire burn. And this evening we're joined by one of our trustees, Ms. Suzanne Stewart, who's with us this evening, also as mom and as a board member. But we need to give a round of applause for our Board of Education, who continues to support music and the arts here in Plainview at Bethpage, not here, but for all the schools and all the programs. Let's give them a rousing round of applause, please. And before we hear these fantastic kids play, I have a few thoughts I'd like to share with you, especially during this holiday season. When I was in high school, which seems like forever ago now, I was introduced to an author named Joseph Campbell. Joseph Campbell, in the 1940s, wrote a book called Hero of a Thousand Faces. And in that book, he talks about what makes a hero. And he went around the world, and he looked at different fairy tales and folklorish myths and things like that. And he discovered that there's three parts to a hero's life: the departure, the fulfillment, and the return. And I thought that was a good allegory to what coming to a concert really is. You drop your kids off and they depart from your presence. While they're on stage, they will fulfill not only themselves, but they will fulfill you. They will fulfill something in our hearts, in our minds, in our souls, everything, and give you the gift of music and share it with us. And when they return to you later, they will be different, and you will be different. And that heroic nature permeates so deeply in the roots that music is. I've had an opportunity to really listen to all of the groups that will be performing tonight. And I can honestly say, in my experience, you're in for a very special concert. These kids and these teachers have done a fantastic job. And this is not only one of the best concerts you will hear in your time here in Plainview at Bethpage, but if you were to travel to other schools doing their concerts around Long Island, you would find this is probably one of the best, if not one of the finest quality ones you will hear. Let's give that a round of applause. But finally, the most important thanks must be given to you, the parents and guardians of our students, because without your support at home, things like tonight wouldn't happen. You are your children's first music teachers, and you have supported them through their journey to be here, and in many ways, you're also a teacher. So kids, clap for your parents. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I have spoken enough. Who's ready to hear some fine music from these kids? Without further ado, I'd like to present the Chamber Orchestra under the direction of Maestro Glenn Rubin.
Thank you. Thank you. Mr. Rogers, that's why you're the music director. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to bring your attention to the program notes. This is a new tradition we're starting. We have a series of pieces we have done and are doing tonight, and we have student volunteers who have written a program note for each of those pieces. You'll find their names after each of the pieces. I'd like to ask those students in the orchestra who have authored program notes tonight to please stand up and be recognized. Thank you. And on with Holiday Peace, the march from Tchaikovsky's ballet, The Nutcracker.
Sergei Rachmaninoff was a famous pianist of about the 1910s, 1920s. He wrote three very beautiful concerti for piano and orchestra, but as well he wrote some very beautiful symphonies. He was known as a master of melody and harmony. I think when you hear this piece you will agree that there's some very, very beautiful and enchanting melodies within this adagio from the second symphony.
Thank you. Thank you.
I have to say that of all the music we play when it comes to the winter concert, this is the piece that the alumni base the concert on. So here is Sleigh Ride 2017.
Considered membership, we encourage you to contemplate joining the MAPOP Association. They really do a lot to provide scholarships and opportunities for our students and have such a great presence here in the district. And tonight, President of MAPOC and several of the board members are here with us this evening. So let's give them a round of applause for all that they do to support our students as well. And without further ado, I'd like to present the High School Jazz Lab under the direction of Mr. David Hirsch.
Thank you very much. So thank you for being so patient, and this is the fastest we've ever set up before. Our first selection is called Jive Samba, and it's a classic Latin tune. It was recorded by American jazz trumpeter Nat Adderley, and it was later recorded by his brother, saxophonist Cannonball Adderley. There are two reasons why this piece is called Jive Samba. One is that Adderley combined two distinct styles of music. He combined a jive, which was like the jitterbug back then, with the Latin samba, and that's why it's called Jive Samba. But there's actually another reason why it's called Jive Samba, and I may be dating myself, but that's okay. The other reason is that the samba is jive, is that the very beginning of the melody, he uses a riff that was used for the punchline of Rowan Martin's Laugh In. I don't know if you remember the da-da-da-da-da-da. It was on Rowan and Martin's Laugh In, and he put that in the song. So I want you guys to listen for that when that shows up, and don't laugh, though. Okay. So Jive Samba grew in popularity due to its easily danceable rhythm and its melody. Hope you enjoy it. We have some soloists. On trumpet, we have Griffin Hoffman. And on trombones, we have Andrew Jang and Matan Marcus Newman. And on alto sax, we have Ethan Lander.
Thank you.
guys hear that? Did you hear it? All right. Next is a song written by Bobby Timmons, who was an American jazz pianist and composer. Thank you. Okay. What was I saying? Oh, yeah. Bobby Timmons was an American jazz pianist and composer. He was a sideman in Art Blakey's Jazz Messengers, a very popular jazz group in the bebop era, as well as being a member of Cannonball Adderley's band. Several of this guy's charts, including Monin, This Year, and the song we're about to play, That There, I guess This Year and That There makes sense, I don't know, enjoyed commercial success and brought him much attention in the jazz world. Timmons was strongly associated with the type of jazz called soul jazz, very simple and very delicate, and he helped initiate that style. So we hope you enjoyed That There, and we have three soloists, Brian Burke on guitar. I see you guys stand up. Sam Karp on bass. And Ethan Lander on alto sax.
Thank you.
All right, we have a lot of soloists on that one. The last number that we're going to play is from a group called AWB, or Average Black Band. That's what they were called. And they were a Scottish funk and R&B band who had a series of soul and disco hits between 1974 and 1980. And they're best known for their instrumental mega hit, Pick Up the Pieces. Believe it or not, I was shopping at ShopRite and I heard Pick Up the Pieces over the loudspeaker.
Really?
All right, it's cool. The band's strength, it means they're getting a lot hipper, ShopRite, with the songs that they play, you know? The band's strength actually lay in their consistently accomplished songwriting, and they stretch across many, many gold albums, Grammy Awards, and this group was responsible for bringing funk and soul to the disco scene of the 70s. So that's why this is a pretty important song. It's Pick Up the Pieces. We have two soloists, Ellie Blum on trombone and Jared Pardo on guitar.
Thank you.
So before you is the high school jazz ensemble. To be in this ensemble, you do have to audition and you have to have participated in the jazz land as well, which you just heard under the direction of Mr. Hirsch. But this evening, we welcome to play viola at Paige in his first concert, our new high school band director, Mr. Brian Carter, in the high school band director. And Mr. Carter has a lot to celebrate as he's recently engaged as well. Mr. Carter, turn it over to you.
Hi everyone, good to see you all tonight. Yes, I did recently get engaged. I'm the luckiest man in the world. My fiance Sierra is sitting right over there. She's completely mortified on this. So the first tune that we're going to play for you all tonight is a John Coltrane tune called Impressions. I picked it because it gave us an opportunity to really work through a lot of functional harmony, play some modes. Modes are pretty much different degrees of the scale besides scales B1. This features solos by Mitch Indeck on val trombone, Josh Siever playing tenor sax on this tune, we're doing bass sax on the tune later on for us, Lexi Wiener on vibraphone, and also Ethan Lander on tenor saxophone. You guys can hear also on drums, Mr. Ethan Chaffin. And there's a nice little unison solo even with the rest of the group. Hope you all enjoy. This is Impressions, John Coltrane.
Thank you.
John
Okay, so this next thing we're going to do is a Mongo Santa Maria tune called Afro Blue. John Coltrane also covered this in the 60s. I found a really cool recording of a modern pianist by the name of Robert Glasper that he actually put it in a different time signature and he made it a little bit more funky. So this is Afro Blue, rearranged in 4-4 as opposed to 3-4. The solo section is going to feature Ju Lee on piano, Josh Seaver on tenor saxophone, Jack Gross on guitar, Ethan Chaffin on congas, and we're going to switch over to Lexi Wiener on the drum set. So this is Afro Blue. Thank you. Okay. The next tune that we're going to do for you tonight is called Tenorbot. I had the pleasure of going to grad school at Queens College's Aaron Copland School of Music. You know, at a time when I kind of needed some more motivation. I was in a weird place in my career. And whenever you need that, it always feels like the right thing comes around just in time. And I met a man by the name of Tim Armacost, who was my saxophone teacher there. And we had a lot of really great sessions. And I said to him that I wanted to do something in my first jazz concert in Plainview that I could honor him with. So I asked him for one of his original pieces of music, and he said, sure, right away. He sent it over to me the same day, so I wrote an arrangement of this for our folks here. We've had a lot of fun playing it. So this is Tim Armacost's Tenorbot. It will feature Reese Ortenberg on bass. When we get to the solo section, we switch back over to Ethan Chalvin for drums, and I hope you guys enjoy it. For our last tune, we're going to do a Freddie Hubbard piece called Red Clay. This is undoubtedly our band's favorite. We're going to have a couple of soloists on this one. But before we do that, this is our last one. I just wanted to announce everybody one last time. On piano, we've got June Lee. On guitar, we've got Kevin Willis. On bass, Lee Skirtler. On drums and vibraphone, we've got Lexi Vino. On drums and cymbals, we've got Ethan Chalfin. On trombone, we've got Ming Kang Choi. On valve trumpet, we've got Mitch Hinder. Trumpet, we've got John Butter. Apple sax, Greg Keyes. Tenor sax, Ethan Lander. And tenor and barry sax, this is Josh Siegel. Thank you guys so much for listening. Thank you.
chameleon!
Thank you guys for listening. This is a great group. I've had a lot of fun working with them, and I could not have had more fun my first one here. Hopefully it's going to be one of many great ones. Thank you everyone. And everybody here in Plainville, West Page, we wish you and your families happy holidays and a wonderful new year. We'll see you in 2018.